Yeah, as I say, a big round of applause for him coming all the way over here. Yeah.
Good. Can you hear me down there? You can hear me over there? So I'm going to be doing multiple clinics throughout the tournament. So today's putting, and then tomorrow's driving. And hopefully we can talk Simon to be my demonstrator like he has in my other clinics. Because my knee's not doing too well, and he throws a lot further than me. So hopefully we can get him to throw tomorrow over in the driving. We'll cover some basic biomechanics tomorrow. But today we're just going to cover a little putting. It won't be a long clinic, because we got to get back out there before it's too late and get you guys in another round. So, first thing I want to talk about is how to grip a putter, and then why, and then we'll work into some techniques. So, if you want to pull out a putter and play along with me, if not, you don't have to, you can just listen. It's all up to you. So, and the other stuff I'm going to teach you over the weekend, that none of that's my opinion. It's going to be biomechanics that I learned while I was going to college. I teach people straight from golf and other sports, just straight biomechanics that makes sense. Putting, on the other hand, is a lot of opinion. So I'm going to do my best to show you how most of the different players do it and why they do it the way they do it, and then you can decide how you like it. Does that make sense, everybody? So basically, when you grip the putter, almost 90% of putters either have this little bead or a lip. And that's designed to be in your one index finger line in, right here. It's designed to be there, and the reason for that is as you putt, if it's in that line, it'll be touching the least amount of skin possible, so you won't get that wobble on your putt. If you have your finger out here, your timing would have to be perfect every time, like Paul Macbeth, or you'll get a little wobble. Does that make sense to everybody? So that's the first point. Where you put your thumb is exactly how you'd write, eat, and you put it down so it'd be just like a pen. That's how you pick anything up. You don't want it over here, you don't want it over here, you want it directly over top of it. Everybody's hand's different. So my thumb's here, some would be here, some would be closer to the edge. Wherever this can happen. Okay? Now putting the rest of your hand under the disc, there's multiple opinions on that, and I'll give you the reasons for each one. Most players put the two middle fingers on the plate. It's pretty common. Ken Climo, Paul Macbeth, Simon Lazat, myself, very much designed like this. The next part is what's different for everybody. Some of the players like Nicola Castro, Barry Schultz, they just let their pinky sit on the plate like this. Players like myself, Ken Climo, we tuck our pinky into the edge. And the reason we tuck our pinky in the edge is that gives us the back of the disc support and the front. If your hand's just on it, it's kind of loose, and you have a gap. If you put your pinky in, you'll have no gap in your hand. You'll get a clean flush release by pushing down on the disc instead of spinning with the front of the disc. Does that make sense to everybody? So when you throw it, it's best to be handsy on top instead of spinny. Get to the reasons that why, but that's why we use the grip that way. Now, you can grip a putter any way you want. It doesn't really matter to me, but if you don't do it similar way I showed you, you'll find a lot of wobble. And it's okay to putt with wobble. Some of the best putters in the world use a little wobble on their putt. It doesn't mean that you're not any good, okay? So, in disc golf, there's basically three styles of putting. Spin putting, push putting, and what some people have labeled in the last 10 years, spush putting. Which is kind of a combination of spin and push. It looks something like Steve Rico's putt. Have you ever seen videos of Steve Rico? He's one of the top American players. Go home and download him. You'll see that he has a very good example of a spush putt, which I'll show you today. So what we're going to do is start with this push putt. So if you want, we'll make a big circle all the way around the bucket. This is an interactive clinic if you're done eating. You don't have to just listen. So everybody make a circle, grab a putter. All right. First thing that you're gonna need to do is find your most athletic position. Many of you probably stand in a way that your friend told you to, or you just kind of did it the first time without thinking about it. And what you wanna do is find a position that you can be the most athletic from. So that would be a fighting position, He's about to do it right there. Some people say falling from a building like a cat position. But basically, what you're going to want to do is stand shoulder length apart, kind of jump a little bit up. You don't have to get crazy with it, and turn to your dominant side. So if you're right-handed, you're going to turn so your right leg's forward. If you're left-handed, you're going to turn so your left leg's forward. It looks very simply like this. And however you land, I'm going to adjust to you. So everybody play it, try it, and then stay there, don't leave. Okay, now, the only adjustment you'll need to make, because you're a little sideways as you look down at your feet, is that as you land this way, you're going to want to turn your right foot and your left foot a hair. Not all the way to center, but just a little off center. And you're going to look at the basket, wherever you're standing, and draw an imaginary line from the pole through the ball of your foot and out your back heel. So if the ball of your front foot and your back heel are touching the exact same line, that's going to be different for a lot of you. And the reason for that is so that you can bend your knees. This way you're able to shift from front to back on bent knees. And what I see a lot of players doing, and especially a lot of the top American players, they're tending to come back and punt from extended knee, like this. This is going to cause no power on the from the legs and just an arm movement, and very difficult to get good at. You want to be able to shift forward onto a bent knee and then lift your arm. Okay? That way you can sustain the weight and you don't have any knee problems, and you find yourself lasting a lot longer in the sport. Can you hear me over here? Okay? So everybody's in that position. Now, to push putt, it's a bad name. Many of you maybe have tried it and it didn't work too well for you, and that's because they called it the wrong thing. It should never have been called the push putt, ever. It should be called the shovel putt, okay? Because the motion is a shoveling motion, to shovel under something. And I want you to imagine that you have a limbo pole in front of you when you get ready to putt this putt, and your object is to putt under the limbo pole with your putter. Now, how do you do that without holding the angle weird? Is that many of you are holding the putter out nice and flat when you start putting, and what happens is when you bring the disc down, look where it's at. So then when you go to push it up, if you don't get it all the way up perfect, it comes out nose down. You lose a lot of power. Most of the top pros are holding the disc completely nose up, where we can read it like this, like it's flat. So that when we come down, now it's perfectly flat, and when we push it forward, it stays flattened up. That's a big difference to putting. Even a lot of players in America who struggle with the push putting really try to lift their arm, but see how when they do that, they lift the nose. Like to get into the basket, it's way too difficult. You're going to want to learn how to shovel under. So it looks something like this. Hold your arm out, and I want you to shovel under. See how the disc comes out nice and flat with the nose up? Everybody, we're going to try it on three, and I'm going to give you commands. One is bend your knees and hold the disc out. Two is drop the disc, but make sure it's nose up. Three will just be to push it forward and release it. It'll go all over the place. Don't measure yourself by your first try. Here we go.
Just
one.
With the pinky tucked in, right?
Yep. Pinky tucked in. One, two, lift. Let's go back to that position and let's add some things so it makes it easier so you can start getting better at it. Those of you who are downwind there into a headwind up the hill, it's going to be a lot more difficult to learn. I would pick this open space over here if I was trying to learn it. Nobody's using the best spot to learn from, which is right here, actually. That's the worst spot to learn from because even the best in the world make me be happy. Now, you're in that position, you're getting ready to lift, everybody should be in putting position. A couple things I want to talk to you about is how to get it there and how to stroke it. Don't laugh at me when I say things like that. So first thing is, your right arm and your left leg are connected on a string for perfect balance. So you want to make sure you, as you scoop up and you lift up your right arm, that you lift your left leg at the same time. Your right arm and left leg will make a perfect match. Okay? That's the first thing. The second thing is, and it's going to be tough for a lot of you, is you don't move your head around. I'm seeing a lot of you as you're putting, you're going down with your head and back up with your head. You want to keep your head and your chin out and still looking at the target. Let your arm and body drop while your head stays in position. I make a lot of my students at the university putt with a putter on their head. Okay? Because that'll keep their balance. You can use their legs to lower their body instead of their shoulders. Okay? Let's try it again. This time, lift your back leg as you scoot up and really accelerate. Now, I can spend hours teaching you guys putting, but we don't have hours, so we're going to be racing through it. Right?
Let's go.
Now, the next thing is, and this is really crucial. I'll tell you guys a quick little story. A couple years back, I was playing pretty well. I got to this point in about September of the season for us, which is late. We got to a major at the PDGA, center, the first one, and I could not make it in the basket. I lost it. I don't know what it was. It was like something off a movie. No matter what I did, it would not go in the basket. And Ken Climo, I went to him. He's a good friend of mine. And I sat down. I said, please, champ, I need a day of help. Watch me putt. Watch me play. What am I doing wrong? It was a very simple change, and now I concentrate on doing it every time, and I putt much better. Which is how to create the stroke. Many people are lining up and they're dropping a stroke like that really fast. What you want to do is concentrate on dropping your stroke very slow and increasing only on the way up. So it looks more like this pace, it's very slow, and then on the way up it's fast. Okay? That concept of complete acceleration will cause you to get a much better release. And you won't get that nose down factor where you wobble out because your timing's off. So you want to concentrate on coming down really slow and then scooping up to nice speed. All right, let's try it again. This time, come down really slow. On your own pace, I'm not going to count. Really give it a little push. There it is. Oh. Putting, the wind plays completely different. I'd like for you guys to think about that for a second. When you're push putting, if you're putting into a headwind, your disc is now going to drop. And if you're putting on a tailwind, your disc is now going to carry. The opposite of what you probably think already. Okay? And when you're putting, no matter what putt, wherever you expose the side of the disc to, you have to make sure the wind's not on that side. So if the wind's right to left, basically, you want to turn your putt into a headwind putt and put the edge of the disc down against the wind and allow it to flatten into the basket. If the wind's coming left to right, you want to putt it with a high, again, pushing the wind on the opposite side of the plate, pushing your disc down into the basket. Does that make sense, everybody? It's the opposite of what you should know now. So if you're confused about it, think about what you do now and think the opposite. All right? So, any questions about push putting while I got you here? I'm going to switch to spin putting and then pushing. I know it's quick, but we don't have all day. Any questions?
I think it's a spin putting.
A little question is how to get power. One thing I left out a little bit is as you hold it out, I see a lot of people like this. Curl it in. Not so it's like this or anything, but so it's comfortably curled. And as you come up, you open your hand. You don't flip your wrist, but you just open your hand, kind of like shaking hands with the basket. It'll create a natural rotation. Make sense? Yep. Any other questions about push putting? Nothing? You gotta go. Under. Duet. You gotta go. Under. Under the pole. Ricky Wysocki's a great example if you want when you're at home. Download some videos of him playing. He really gets low and comes from under. All right? Okay.
Does that prevent low putts?
Yeah. Well, I mean, everybody hits them low. Don't worry.
Right.
Help. My other half says if the game was to hit the basket, I'd be best again. So I'm really good. kind of hitting here the last couple of years. So, all right, now, spin putting. There's many, many, many different ways to spin putt. But let's just use the Paul McBeth theory, since I think he's the best putter that's spin putting in the world. Would you say, Simon?
I agree.
All right. So, in this thought process, you're going to be in that same athletic position that we found. Is everybody getting that position? The only difference between his putt and what I'm going to teach you is that instead of generating the power by scooping and creating a scooping motion with your arm being straight, you're going to create a motion with your elbow, but you're going to do it a lot different probably than most of you do it. I watched a lot of people today on the course. I kind of do that, so I know what to teach in the clinic. And I saw most people spun from the hip. They bring it down to this hip, and they kind of swing it across. That's very difficult because you're creating an arch in your line, and it's very difficult to replicate that. You look at the Paul McBeth, and before Paul McBeth, it's a guy named Mike Mosher, who was much better than Paul McBeth at putting. I know that's hard to believe, but he was. And the guy would make a consistent 50 and in all day. And basically, their theory is as you spin putt, you still don't take it off the line. See, a lot of people want to move it different places. If you look closely, they're bringing it down into their body on a perfectly straight line, and then out their body on a perfectly straight line. There is no other side-to-side action, up and down. They usually stand very tall. They don't get really low. They stand above the bucket, and they bring the disc into their chest or their belly button, depending on their height, and they go straight forward. By spinning the wrist open, almost like a paintbrush that goes to the right on a right stroke. And the real trick to it is, I'll tell you after you try it once. Everybody try it once. Here we go. Bring it into your chest. And you want to have as much power as usual. And just go straight out. Go. Okay, now, here's the trick to this. And I taught it when I was here last time. But this is the trick. What you guys have to think about is that you are right-handed and you are brushing the stroke to the right to create that spin. So if you aim in the center, you're going to miss to the right. Just like about 50% of you missed, I watched, just missed to the right or hit the chain. Okay? So what you have to be able to do is know that that's going to happen and start aiming in the left center. If you aim left of the pole and you hit the shot, it will come out right of the pole. I'll give you an example. You look at me right here, you can see my body is lined up left of the pole if you're standing behind me. Can you see that? But watch as my hand comes up with that spin, it just comes out right in front of me, in the center of the basket. If you aim to the middle, you cut the basket in half. You only get this much to hit. If you use the whole bucket and rotate the spin of the disc, you get the whole bucket. I want everybody this time to aim to the left pole and commit to that spin putt and see where it goes. Now, next thing, we're going to go into squish, straddle, jump putt. We'll get you out of here. Don't worry, tomorrow you're going to throw for me, right?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so squish. Many of you were probably uncomfortable with both those styles. A lot of people are really uncomfortable with the full spin in the tournament or the push. So what a lot of these players have done is involved a shot, what I call the spush. And what they're going to do is keep their arm long and straight, kind of like you see Chris Adiago doing, if you see him play it all this week. And basically, he's still going to flick his wrist at the end, but keep his arm in the push putt stance. And it's kind of what Rico and a lot of the players do. You see Ricky Wysocki does it a lot. But basically, they curl it in, they do the same push putt, but they rotate. And they rotate their hand out into a spin putt finish with their hand and a push putt finish with their arm. It's combining the two. So again, it looks like this. They curl it in. They're going to do the push putt throw and the spin putt finish at the same time. And it gives it this spin, like direct looking shot. Give it a try. Curl the wrist, try to hold the arm in the push putt stance. A lot of speed. Don't forget to aim left. You got to aim left. So, same with you two over there. Curl the disc. There it is. Yeah. Curl the disc a little bit to start. Come up and let it out. Aim left. Don't forget to aim left. Now that I got you guys lined up properly, you have to aim left. All right. Moving right along. The straddle putting. It's the fastest putting clinic on earth. Alright, here's straddle putting. There's a couple simple things about straddle putting I saw again today when I watched everybody. I see all over the planet when I go to teach. Is when people line up their straddle putt, they want to do just this. Watch this move right here. Okay? And that's the natural thing to do if you haven't trained yourself. But if you think about it, you're pushing everything away. Pushing everything away. And you want to look at the Barry Schultzes of the world. They're the best straddle putters. They thrust their hips forward, and it looks more like this. I know it seems strange, and they go up onto their toes. They come up high. This way, they're not putting the action backwards. So it's very simple. You just come up, thrust, and try to drop it in. All right, let's try it. Straddle putt. Come up onto your toes. Onto your toes. Really give it something. There it is. Do not drop that butt. Yep, I'll do it again. So watch again. Watch what my feet are doing. They're going up onto the toes and back down to the heel. Yep, you come back and you up onto your toes.
Are you on the flat, whole flat of your feet or heels?
I'm leaning forward more towards the toes.
Okay.
And then I'm coming down, I'm thrusting up. Like literally like you're going like this. Again, download Barry Schultz. Anytime you want, you'll see it step for step, exactly like I just showed you. All right. Moving right along. Am I going fast enough yet? Now we're going to step putting, jump putting. First thing I want to talk to you guys about is legalities of it. How to figure out when to do it, then we'll talk about what's legal and what's not legal. Since you're a new country, you're playing a lot of PGA events. Okay? First thing is, it's not called jump putting. There's nothing in the rule book called jump putting. You're allowed to follow through. Jump putting would be illegal. To jump off the ground and putt is illegal. You must maintain your foot to the ground until the disc is released out of your hand. Then you can jump, flop, roll, dive, anything you want. Okay? And let me show you a couple examples. So I know I'm supposed to be further away, but I just want to show you guys. What I mean by this is, and this is how most of us did, including myself 10 years ago, we didn't know any better until we started seeing videos. And it was just passed along to us, but most people start right foot forward and they jump it in. That's illegal. Okay? You're leaving the ground before the disc is out of your hand, and it's very easy to make it, but it's also very illegal. So something to think about. So years ago, when I sat at home, I thought, how can I get forward still and not do that, right? Because I saw pictures of myself and other top players this high off the ground, jump putting, okay? So I said, well, the rule book says you can walk through the shot. So I decided to come up with this putt, but turned into a pretty popular putt for the young players called the step through. And the reason that is because I'm able to go forward, release the disc, and then touch. Now you gotta make sure, I see a lot of the young players manipulating this, they're more like that, and they're pushing the level. And if you touch even a blade of grass, not the ground, you are foot faulting, okay? So all you wanna do is practice just walking through it. You don't wanna try to run, jump, you just putt. Be able to do it from further distances as you practice. I would recommend practicing it from this distance here. getting the hang of it, then taking it outside the circle to extend your line, you want to get the timing of it. And the timing of it is very simply, what is your right arm connected to, I said at the beginning of the clinic?
Your right, left leg.
Left leg, right? So your right arm and your left leg go forward at the same time. Your left leg goes early, you'll footfall. Your left leg goes late, you'll flop it up in the air. All right, and you see those real wobbly, crappy jump putts on tape we throw sometimes? That's because we went late trying to be on the extra safe side. But if you time it perfectly, your timing will be great. If you bring it in and you go right arm and left leg at the same time, then you'll be perfectly legal. Everybody want to give that a try?
Now that jump that you used to do, that you no longer do, that would get called now.
Yes.
It would, eh?
I think so, yep. Yep. We're talking about some of the states right now.
Yeah, it would get called.
You can see Paul McBeth's and them, they've gone away from it.
So within the feet, I'm doing this, you had to do this within 10 meters.
No, you have to do it outside.
Yeah, that's right.
Try to walk through it. Just keep going, though. Don't stop once you walk. Yep, just keep going like you're going to get it.
Yeah.
Yep. Lastly, how do you know when you're outside the circle if you don't have a great TD who marked all the lines for you?
Ask somebody.
Measure in the bag would work. I mean, I wish we were professional like that. I wish this guy was running my tour.
You ask your partners.
Yeah, the truth of it is you have to walk it. And so I want to give you some basic things to think about when you're walking. If it's perfectly flat, it is not 10 paces. That's passed around the whole world. 10 paces is about 29 feet, okay? Unless you're taller than this guy. So a guy his height, which is about 6'3", 206 or something, okay? A guy that height, 190? Yeah, 194 or something, 600, right? 190 in that range, 6'3", can take 11 paces. 11 full paces for a gentleman that height, we'll put him at the line. If you're my height or lower, you need 12 full paces. Okay? Not 10. 12 full paces to get outside the circle. Now, when you're doing it uphill and downhill, it's very difficult to figure out how far you are away. You're like, wow, it's just right there. It is not how far it is for your disc to fly. It is how far it is for you to walk it. So you could look like it's only 22 feet right here, or 6-7 meters, but if you walked it, it would be 11 meters. That's still good.
Wow.
It's the land.
Yep.
Okay? Something to remember. So downhill ones, a lot of the times, they look a lot longer than they really are because that same effect. Does that make sense to everybody? All right. Last thing I want to give you guys, because I know I got to wrap it up, I can tell by the looks on their faces. There's a couple new things to add to stuff I didn't teach when I was here last time. How to putt on a hill. Just a quick little something I want to show you guys. If you're putting uphill or downhill, you'll find that it's much more difficult than flat land. And the reason for that, that we don't talk about in disc golf, is because the length of your back step is now going to be different because you're either touching more land than you're used to, or you can't reach the land you're used to grabbing. Okay? And so what happens is when you putt uphill, you pull it to the right low, and when you putt downhill, it goes high left, as opposed to down. And the reason for that is because you're not getting the same push with your back leg that you would usually get. So, if you're putting uphill, you need to shorten your stance and aim left of the pole. Because you're going to pull it, because gravity of right-handed side on a hill will make you pull it to the right. So you're going to want to pit a shorter step and really push it up the hill with more aggression. If you have your foot back, you're going to reach for it, there's going to be nothing there, and you're going to putt it like this. Okay, and you'll see that's a drastic example, but a little bit of that makes it hard to make the putt. Vice versa, when you're downhill, I see a lot of people, because they're downhill and it's a downhill thing, most people stand with their feet close together because of heights. That's not how you want to putt downhill, though. If you putt with your feet close together, you're going to get this instant push and give it way too much speed. You want to get your foot really far back where it's up on this land that's about right here, and then be able to just give it the nice, same movement. Being able to think about your anchor, which is your back foot, will really help you with the uphill, downhill putts. Does that make sense to everybody? I wish I could teach you a lot more about it. I think I have a lot more to teach tomorrow. I can teach a lot more next time I come. If we're going to run out of daylight, we got to get to the steak and the beer. So I'd like to thank Simon and New Zealand Club. I'm proud to be a part of the double spin. And I look forward to meeting many of you I haven't met. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
And And hey, just one more thing. Dave's around the whole weekend, and he's a very approachable guy.
Yep.
So if you have any questions,
come right up to me.
Yeah, come up to him and ask him.